Good morning, friends. In this session, let me explain the concept of gate drains. So, in the power transmission, to get a higher speed reduction, the regular gate drive may not be effective. So, gate drains are used to get higher speed reduction. The meshing of two or more number of gates to get higher speed reduction is nothing but a gate drain. It gives a higher speed reduction ratio, and it is the main advantage of a gate drain over the simple gate drives. The gate drain consists of all varieties of gates, spur gates, helical gates, bevel gates, worm gates, and so on. So there are mainly five types of gate drains. Number one, simple gate drain. Number two, compound gate drain. Reverted gate drain. 4. Epicyclic gate drain. 5th one. Compound epicyclic gate drain. So these are the five varieties of gate drains which are commonly used in the power transmission. The type of gate drive used in the application, given application, it depends on two factors. The first factor is the velocity ratio required or the speed ratio required, and the second one is the relative position and orientation of the shafts on which the gates are mounted. Second factor we need to consider while selecting the type of gate drain is relative position. Relative position and orientation of the shafts on which the gates are mounted. So the first three gates, simple gate drain, compound gate drain, and reverted gate drain, the shafts are fixed in its positions. The shafts are fixed in its positions, whereas in the epicyclic gate drain and compound epicyclic gate drains, the shafts are not fixed. These are moved with respect to others, right? So let me explain the first type of gate drain, simple gate drain. So this is a simple gate drain. The pictorial representation of a simple gate drain gives us a view how the simple gate drain appears. The driver rotates in clockwise sense and the follower rotates in anti-clockwise sense, right? So this is how the simple gate drain is represented. Now, to find out the velocity ratio of this simple gate train, you can consider N1 by N2. Speed ratio is equal to the speed of the driver divided by speed of the follower. That is equal to N1 by N2. This you can express in terms of diameters. Let us take D1 and D2 are the diameters of driver and the follower. Obviously, N1 by N2 is equal to D1 by D2. But you can express the pitch circle diameters in terms of number of teeth, MT1 divided by MT2. Where M is the module here. From this, you can express speed ratio N1 by N2 is equal to D2 by D1. N1 by N2 is equal to D2 by D1. D2 can be expressed MT2 divided by MT1. That is equal to the module gets cancelled in the numerator and denominator, thereby T2 by T1. T2 by T1. So this is speed ratio in the case of simple gate train. Simple gate train. Okay. Then train value, and the second parameter which is used to find out the performance of the simple gate train is the train value, that is equal to 1 by speed ratio. 1 by speed ratio N2 by N1 equal to T1 by T2. This is train value for simple gate train. Right. Suppose if the distance between the shafts is very large, if the distance between the two shafts is very large, then that gap between the two shafts can be compensated by considering large gear wheels or gear wheels of larger diameter. Suppose if this is the input shaft and this is the output shaft, right? In between these two, if you want to transmit the power, right? I have the driver of this diameter, I have the follower of this diameter. Then the gap between these two gear wheels is filled by another gear wheel. Another gear wheel like this, and this gear wheel is mounted on another shaft called intermediate shaft. Okay, and this gear is intermediate gear. So this is, so now this is driver and this is follower and this is intermediate gear. This intermediate gear is known as idle gear. Idle gear. Okay, now as the driver rotates in clockwise direction with N1 RPM, the intermediate gear or idler gear rotates in the opposite sense, that is counterclockwise direction, with certain RPM. Let us take N2 here, and the third gear, follower gear, which is output gear, rotates in clockwise direction with N3 RPM. That means the driver and follower both are rotating in the same sense here. Driver and the follower rotating in the same sense by considering an intermediate gear. What is the name given for this intermediate gear? Idle gear. Okay, so that's how the distance between, if the distance between the shafts is very large, then the power is transmitted from driver to follower by considering idler gear as the one option, and other option is by increasing the diameters of driver and the follower pulleys But increasing of the diameters of driver and follower pulleys may not be economical, as right? So it increases the cost of the gear wheel, and at the same time, it may not be correct as far as the design is concerned. As the size increases, the weight of the gear wheel increases. As the weight increases, there is a chance of the deformation of the shaft on which the gears are mounted. So that deformation may cause the shaft misalignments. Obviously, the second option of increasing the diameters of driver and the follower is not at all suitable to fill the gap between the shafts which are located at farther distances, right? That's why the concept of idler gear is best suited for this problem, right? Now here, how many idler gears are used here? One idler gear. If you use one idler gear, the driver and follower both are rotating in the same sense. Similarly, if I use two idler gears, the driver and follower gears rotates in opposite sense, right? Here both are rotating in the same sense, and here both are rotating in the opposite sense. Similarly, if we consider three gears, once again, both driver and follower rotates in the same sense. Okay. Similarly, if I consider four gears, once again, driver rotates in clockwise, follower rotates in anti-clockwise. That means even number of idler gears in the simple gear train gives opposite rotation to the driver and the follower. Odd number of idler gears in the simple gear train gives same sense of rotation for both driver and the follower. Okay, so now we'll consider the velocity ratio. Let us take the driver consists of T1 number of teeth here. The intermediate gear consists of T2 teeth. The follower gear consists of T3 teeth. Then speed ratio is equal to, first you consider speed ratio of first gear drive. That means between driver and the intermediate gear. SR1 is equal to N1 by N2 is equal to T2 by T1. Similarly, between second and third gates, SR2 is equal to N2 by N3 is equal to T3 by T2. Now the speed ratio is equal to speed ratio 1 into speed ratio 2. That means one suffix for first gate drive, that between 1 and 2, two suffix for second gate drive 2 and 3. Therefore, N1 by N2 into N2 by N3. Two gets cancelled, you will get N1 by N3. N1 by N3, that is equal to, here you will get T2 get cancelled, then you will get T3 by T1. Now if you observe the speed ratio equation, N1 by N3 is equal to T3 by T1. Is there any suffix 2 here? So that means there is no importance of this idler gear in the power transmission in the simple gear train analysis, right? So that's why this gear is named as idler gear, right? It is, this function of idler gear is only to get a higher speed reduction and to fill the gap between the shafts which are located at farther distances, and the main function is to decide the sense of rotation of the driven member or the follower. Okay, so the functions of idler gear is to decide the sense of rotation of the follower, and second one is to fill the larger center distance between the driver and the follower. These two are the functions of idler gears. Okay, so if the speed ratio is N1 by N3, what is the train value? N3 by N1. So this is regarding a simple gear train. I hope it is clear. Thank you.